Many of our streams and rivers in the United States and Canada have become saltier and more alkaline over time. When you think of salt, you think of sodium chloride, probably your table salt. But salts refer to a wide variety of different compounds in water. Salt pollution has impacts on drinking water supplies. It can affect aquatic organisms and biodiversity. It can also enhance the mobilization of metals and other pollutants like nitrate and phosphate. For example, in Flint, Michigan, there was an issue with metals contamination in the drinking water supply from the Flint River, which had higher salt content, which could affect the corrosivity of the water. This isn't an isolated case just in Flint, Michigan. Our study looked at the salinization of freshwater and the alkalization of freshwater on the North American continent. And we realized that there's what we call a freshwater salinization syndrome that's contributing to the increase in these multiple salts. We're faced with the challenge of what to do with this information. We can continue to let these salts accumulate, or we could decide to manage or regulate these salts. There are multiple solutions that can be implemented to manage and regulate salts. We use road salts in the United States in the winter months. However, we rely on old infrastructure to spread these salts. So we could use more effective spreading equipment. We could apply these salts as brines before snow events. We could focus on placing new development further away from streams and rivers. In agricultural areas, we could also manage salts by controlling our fertilizer use. As a society, it's up to communities, managers, people, and politicians to make the decision on whether they want to curb this problem.